On Sunday, Turkey will hold elections that many believe could have a profound impact on the U.S., Israel, and the Middle East. Here's CBN News correspondent Chris Mitchell.
Turkey is in the final days of a campaign that will affect one of the U.S.'s biggest Middle East allies for years to come. The elections center around one party and one man.
Here in Istanbul, it's hard to escape posters of Turkish Prime Minister Erdogan, the head of the ruling Islamist party called the AKP. Polls point to a sizable victory by the AKP, and that would mean the third straight election win for a party that's worked hard to make one of the most secular Muslim nations in the earth more and more Islamic.
I don't think that we're going to have sharia or anything like people fear, but we are going more to the, I guess, Middle Eastern roots.
Political adversaries say the world is finally seeing the real Erdogan. CBN News found the number two man in Turkey's main opposition party campaigning in Istanbul's main square.
The dear prime minister in America and Europe was very popular, and they supported him in 2004 and 2007. And his mask looked very liberal. But now they see that he is not liberal. He is restricted freedom, and the journalists can't express themselves because of the prime minister. Therefore, the mind of Erdogan is fascist, and it is a dictatorial regime.
Some accuse the AKP of using democracy to gain power and then limit freedoms. We asked Erdogan's second in command about those charges.
Turkey has never been as democratic as she is today. Mm-hmm. Some people might not enjoy the fact that Turkey is becoming a stronger country. We can understand their feelings, but Turkey is becoming more and more democratic every day.
But if Erdogan's party wins a majority of seats in the election, some fear he'll rewrite Turkey's constitution, set up a presidential system, and consolidate his power. The AKP party is closely linked to the worldwide Gulen Islamic movement, and some even feel he hopes to reestablish an Islamic caliphate with Turkey as its head. Whatever the outcome of Sunday's elections, Turkey will be a different country come Monday. What kind of country is still to be decided. That's why many Christians in the Middle East are praying for Turkey and the future of the region.
As Christians, we have a very special calling. No matter what the government is, whether it's evil or whether it's good, we need to pray for them. We need to bless them. And we need to pray that they would also recognize, realize the gospel of the Lord Jesus Christ, come to know it, come to accept it, because God wants the salvation of all men.
Chris Mitchell, CBN News, Istanbul.